Good evening. Welcome tonight, friends. Great to see you in the Lord's house. Amen. Welcome. We got a wonderful night planned. We're going to celebrate a couple things tonight. We're going to be receiving some members into the life of our church. Do that in just a moment. And then a little bit later in the service, we will be celebrating believers' baptism. So we're very excited about tonight. And I know that many of you have come to watch friends and loved ones and relatives make public their profession of faith in Christ and follow Him in baptism. And it's a great night. We're so glad you're here. If you are from another congregation and another house of worship, welcome to the Forest Hill Church of God family tonight. We're glad you slipped off tonight on a Sunday night to come be here and worship with us from wherever your home church is. Greetings tonight. My name is Pastor Daniel Blaylock. I'm the lead pastor here at the Hill. And you'll be meeting all of our pastoral staff tonight as they step up and help me baptize new believers in water tonight. Amen. So we'll be doing that together in just a moment. I'm very glad that you're here tonight. We want to open with a word of prayer and ask God's blessing on our night. Continue to pray for Pastor Quinley. He's doing well right now. They did keep him at Providence and trying to figure out what the next steps are for him, but they're doing well. We've talked with Rachel and the kids, and keep them lifted up tonight. We'll agree in prayer for them tonight. Amen. Remember Miss Anita Weaver. She is recovering tonight from a stroke as well. She's one of our beloved members. We want to pray for her tonight, lift her up. And I know you probably got some unspoken needs in the house tonight. Anybody? Somebody on your heart tonight? Absolutely. Well, tonight as we begin, let's lift our heart up in prayer. We'll receive in members, and then we'll worship together in song. And I'll come back and invite our candidates for baptism after a couple songs. And we'll let them publicly declare their faith together. And then we'll worship and baptize them tonight. And we will rejoice and celebrate with them as they do that. Amen. So let's lift our heart up tonight to the Lord in prayer. Will you pray with me tonight? Father, we love you and thank you. It is an honor and privilege to be in the presence of God. We thank you tonight that, Lord, we are your called out people, the church of the living God, who've gathered tonight because we love you. We ask that you would pour out your spirit on us, Lord, who've gathered to worship tonight. We ask tonight that you just bless this evening. We pray that you would forever seal the memory of it to the heart of those who are being baptized in water. And we ask you tonight for your blessing and your grace on it all. In Jesus' strong, mighty name, and his people said, amen. Give the Lord a great hand of praise tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. All right. I'm going to ask Mark and Lisa to join us tonight. I had several that came through our membership class. And if you're here tonight and you're on tap to join tonight as one of our members, I know Mark and Lisa are. And I may be overlooking someone tonight. If I am, don't let me do that to you. You step on up. But those are the two that I've seen tonight who completed our membership class at the Hill. If you want to join the Forest Hill Church of God, the way to do that is just to let us know that. If you text new to our guest number, we will get back in touch with you on how to do that. Normally we do classes during the Sunday school time. Right now, with things being a little off schedule from normal, we're not doing that, so we're going to be doing classes online where you can watch the videos of the sessions, and then we'll do a face-to-face meeting together at the end of that time and make sure that you understand what that is. Our classes are very simple. We spend a day talking about the Forest Hill Church. We spend a day talking about what it means to be part of the Church of God. And we spend a day just talking about why membership matters in general. And so it's a great time together. And then we come into the life of the church. Amen. So tonight it's great to have Mark and Lisa Bailey with us. And I just want to ask you guys some questions and receive you into the membership of our church. And then pray for you tonight before we move on tonight. Amen. So Mark and Lisa, I ask you tonight, do you publicly confess that you know the Lord Jesus in the full pardon of your sins? Are you willing to walk in the light of the Scripture as it shines on your path? Are you willing to be faithful to the local church and support it with your time and attendance and your financial gifts to the best of your ability as the Lord prospers you? Are you willing to be subject to the admonition of those who are over you in the Lord? And are you willing to abide by the teachings of the Church of God as set forth in the minutes of the General Assembly? Well, then it is my great honor and delight to receive you into the membership of the Forest Hill Church of God and to be the first one to greet you tonight and offer you the right hand of fellowship. I know you will be a blessing to the church and that the church will be a blessing to you. And we love you guys and we're just grateful to have you. Amen. Amen. I want you to stand tonight and extend your hands their direction and let's just pray God's blessing on them tonight as I come down and we receive them as members tonight. Amen. Would you help me tonight as we pray? Lord, in the name of Jesus, I just love you and thank you tonight, Lord. Lord, for Mark and Lisa, for their family, Lord God, and all that they mean to this church. Lord, we give you your praise and honor tonight just for sending them our way and folding them into the life of this congregation. Lord, we love them, and we know that you've sent them here, Lord, to be blessed and to be a blessing. And they already have been, Lord. And I just pray tonight that, God, you would continue to do that. We receive them into the fellowship of this church tonight officially. They've already been ours, but we just want to mark the moment tonight and recognize that they're here and they're part of our family. And, Father, we thank you for them. We pray your blessing on them tonight in every way. We bring them under the covering of this church, and we pray that, God, you would extend over their lives every benefit of being part of this congregation. Lord, we receive them as part of our church family, and we ask you tonight to bless them physically and mentally, emotionally and spiritually, financially and in every way. Lord, we pray that, Lord, every blessing that is ours in Christ would just rain down over their lives tonight. We pray that you would keep them and strengthen them to walk with you, and that, Lord, they would always, Lord, have a place here to find support and strength and to use their gifts and abilities in serving the kingdom of Christ. And we'll bless you and thank you for it in Jesus' strong name. And God's people said, amen. Amen. Would you give them a hand tonight and welcome them to the life of our church? Love you guys. Amen. Amen. What a great, stay standing with me tonight. Amen. It is a great night to worship and to celebrate. And we're going to lift our voice in songs of praise. We'll be back in just a moment as our baptism candidates, all these guys in the blue shirts tonight will be stepping up and celebrating tonight. And we'll introduce you to them in just a moment. Amen. But before we go any further tonight, would you lift your heart and lift your voice and sing with us and shout with us. And let's just rejoice and celebrate tonight in the goodness of the Lord and lift our voice in songs of praise tonight. One more time, would you give God a great hand of praise and gratitude and worship tonight? Amen. Lead us to
the whole song unto the Lord, all ye land. Amen. Amen. Serve the Lord with gladness. And that's why we've come tonight, to celebrate, to acknowledge who he is and what he's done in our lives. Amen. One more time, can you just put your hands together and praise him? Hallelujah, Lord.
Oh, I was buried beneath my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight? It was my tomb till I met you.
Say, I was breathing.
I was breathing, but not. All my failures I tried to hide.
It was my tomb.
It was my tomb.
Till I met you.
Till I met you.
You call my.
You call my name. And I ran out of that grave. Out of the darkness. Into your glory.
Let's testify right now. Say, I need it.
I need a rescue. My sin was heavy, but chains break at the weight of your glory. I needed shelter. I was an orphan. Now you call me a citizen of heaven. When I was broken, you were my healing. Now your love is the air that
shout of praise in the house of God tonight. Amen. Is that your testimony tonight? Is that your story tonight? Amen. That's our story. That's our testimony. Hear the word of the Lord before we're seated tonight. And you he made alive who were dead in trespasses and sins, in which you once walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit of disobedience, who now works in the sons of disobedience, among whom we also had our conduct, conducting ourselves in the lust of the flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature children of wrath just as others. But God, say it with me, but God, who is rich in mercy, because of his great love with which he loved us, even when we were dead in trespasses and sins, made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved, and raised us up together, and made us sit together in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus, that in the ages to come he might show the exceeding riches of his grace in his kindness toward us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. Yes. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest anyone should boast. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them. And somebody said amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give the Lord a great hand of praise. Amen. The Lord reigns. The Lord reigns. The Lord reigns. Blessed be the name of the Lord. You can be seated tonight in his presence. I want to invite our candidates for baptism to come tonight and join me. Just stand right along here and face me, if you will. Just line up along the front. No particular order. Amen. Just come and join me down front here. And look this way, Elijah. Y'all turn this way. I want you to be able to see the screens, and that's going to help you, okay, for just a moment when we make a commitment together. Amen. So you want to get where you can see a screen. Come on down. Amen. And we're excited about tonight. Amen. Great group of people who are coming to be baptized. I want to explain the crew that we've got down here tonight. It is a mixed multitude. Amen. It's a good-looking group, and we're excited. Several of our people tonight are first-time people being baptized, the first-time profession of faith in Christ. They are announcing their union with Christ, their faith in Christ tonight by being baptized in water. We have a couple people down here tonight who walked with Christ, and sometime along the journey, they stumbled and began to go back into some things of their past, and they have renewed their commitment to Christ. And so tonight, they wanted to do their first works over tonight, which the Bible instructs us to do when we've had a lapse such as that. And it's a way of drawing a fresh line in the sand and saying, from tonight forward, I'm renewing my commitment to Christ, and I'm going to follow him. So we have several that are doing that as well tonight. Amen. And then we have one tonight, Nick. Many of you joined us online a few weeks ago when we needed Nick to be baptized because we were setting him forth for ministry. And you can't be set forth for ministry unless you've been baptized and joined the church, right? So we had a moment up here on a Wednesday morning where we live streamed Nick's baptism, and many of you joined us online and celebrated with us, but we did not want him to be excluded from tonight. So tonight, Nick is going to be remembering his baptism tonight. And we'll be celebrating that moment with him along with the rest of our crew tonight. Guys, tonight I'm excited. We've had a few minutes to meet together before service and talk a little bit about what tonight means. I've asked Pastor John if he will put on the screen for us tonight the commitment that I walked us through this morning at the close of our service. It's a very ancient tradition in the life of the church that before we're baptized in water, that we make it very clear before God and before the devil and before our friends and before our community that we are clear about our commitment, that we are turning our back on the world, the flesh, and the devil, that we're embracing Christ as Lord and Savior, and by his grace and with his help, we're going to live for him going forward. So tonight, we're going to do the most ancient thing. Jesus was baptized, amen? His disciples were baptized, and every Christians in every generation have followed the Lord in baptism, and so we're going to celebrate that tonight. So tonight, I want to ask you some questions, and the screen will help us tonight as we do that. And I want you to just follow along and let's read together. Amen. And I want you to take a moment and publicly, loudly, boldly declare your commitment and your faith tonight and what you intend to do. So as your pastor, I ask you, do you hear in the presence of God and the church, either make for the first time or renew the solemn promise you made at your baptism and commit yourself to keep these promises? If so, please say, I do. Do you renounce the devil and all spiritual forces of wickedness that rebel against God? If so, say, I renounce them. Do you renounce the empty promises and deadly deceits of the world that corrupt and destroy the creatures of God? If so, say, I renounce them. And do you renounce the sinful desires of your flesh that would draw you away from the love of God? If so, shout, I renounce them. Tonight, I want to ask you as your pastor, do you turn in faith to Jesus Christ and confess Him as your Lord and Savior? If so, say, I do. Do you joyfully receive the Christian faith as revealed in the Bible, the Holy Scriptures, the Old and New Testament, the Word of God? If so, say, I do. And finally, will you obediently keep God's holy will and commandments and walk in them all the days of your life? If so, say, I will, the Lord being my helper. I will, the Lord being my helper. Amen. All right. Would you give these guys a hand tonight and celebrate with them? Austin, Tristan, come help me tonight. Amen. I want to ask you to stand again tonight, and I want you to extend your hands this direction. And we're going to, again, something that's an ancient tradition in the church, is that before someone is baptized, we pray over them. They have renounced the world, the flesh, and the devil. They've expressed their faith in the Lord Jesus. And we're believing tonight that when they step into the water of baptism, everything from their old life that's tried to hold on, there's going to be a breaking of that and a severing of that. And God is going to do a mighty work tonight and confirm His grace to them. They're not being baptized in order to get saved. They're already saved. They've trusted Jesus as Savior. What happens in baptism is not salvation, but it is confirmation. The Spirit of God whispers to our heart in baptism that our faith is genuine and that we have been saved and passed from death to life. And it is a symbolic way, sacramental way of leaving the past behind, going down and burying the old, rising up in new life to walk with Jesus in resurrection power. And so tonight, they've rejected and renounced the enemy. We're going to anoint them with oil. We're going to lay hands on them. We're going to command the enemy to take his hands off of them. We're going to plead the blood of Christ over them and ask God to strengthen them for the journey that they're embarking on as Christians and for the Holy Spirit to seal them with His power tonight. Amen. So I want you to stretch your hands this way. We're going to take the next few moments as our musicians play, and we're going to just pray for them and bear them up before the Lord. Would you stretch your hands and let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we love you, and we thank you tonight for each of these candidates of baptism, most of whom are celebrating for the very first time their faith in Christ, others who are renewing a commitment that they wanted to come and share tonight, that they have made a fresh commitment in their heart to Christ. And Lord, some who are just remembering their baptism and need to be renewed in that tonight, their faith and confidence in Christ, their commitment to follow him and serve him. Lord, I pray tonight that, Lord, you would just drive far from them all the power of the evil one. We plead the blood of Jesus over them, and we pray that every chain of darkness would be broken off their lives. We pray that everything from the past would be left behind in the water, and that they would rise tonight in newness of life and walk with Christ with the seal and power of the Holy Spirit upon their lives. And Lord, we'll bless you and thank you for that. And we ask it all in Jesus' strong and mighty name. And everybody said, amen. On the night that Jesus was baptized in water, the Bible says the day Jesus was baptized in water, the Holy Spirit came on him, and a voice spoke from heaven. And the voice said, "You are my beloved Son. With you, I am well pleased." Tonight, what we're celebrating is that you are in Christ. And because you are in Christ, what I pray you hear in your heart tonight when you come up out of the water is the same words that he spoke over his son. You are my beloved child, and with you I am well pleased. Jesus, the Father said that to Jesus before he preached a single sermon, before he worked a single miracle, before he healed anybody or raised anybody from the dead. Jesus was not accepted because of his good works that he was about to do. Jesus was accepted because he was the Father's child. And you are accepted tonight, not because you've measured up or earned it or deserved it, but because you have put faith in Christ. And by faith in Jesus, you have become a son or daughter of God. Amen. And you're accepted in Christ tonight. And I don't know what you walked in here thinking or believing about yourself. My deepest prayer for you tonight is that you will come up out of the water hearing in your heart the voice of your Heavenly Father, louder than every other voice that's ever spoken over you, saying, "You are my kid, and you make my heart happy, and I love you." That's what we want for you tonight. That's what we want for you tonight. Amen? Amen. Our pastoral team is going to lead our candidates out through that door. We're going to line up. And we're going to prepare to be baptized tonight. Pastor Chad's going to lead us. Our team's going to come back and lead us. You remain standing. We're going to sing another song of worship as y'all are going to worship as we get ready. And we're going to sing what these shirts say tonight. I won't go back. That's the declaration these friends are making tonight in Christ. Amen. One more time. Celebrate them as they go get ready. And let's worship together.
And favor,
sing it again.
Lift your hands and thank Him for His grace, that He changed your life. Come on, let the redeemed of the Lord say so right now. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. And I won't go back. I can't go back to the way
we tasted and we know, Lord,
before your presence came and changed me.
One more time, say,
I won't go back. I can't go back to the way it used to be before your presence came and changed me.
More great hand of praise tonight, amen. Worship, celebrate tonight. Amen. Amen. You can be seated tonight. Tonight, we're about to celebrate believers' baptism with our friends tonight. We're going to do them by department and by age group. So Pastor Austin's going to join me in just a second, and we're going to baptize several from our kids' church department tonight. And we'll introduce you. I'll let Pastor Austin introduce each of them. And he's going to ask them about their profession of faith in Christ, and then we will baptize them in water tonight, amen. As we prepare to do that, one more time, would you stretch your hands this way? We're going to ask God's blessing on the waters of baptism. Then we're going to baptize them into Christ. Let's pray. Father, we love you and thank you tonight, Lord, that you've given us the sign, the symbol, the sacrament of water baptism as a way of celebrating what's happened in our hearts. That we, through repentance, have died with Christ. Through faith, have joined him in his death, and tonight his burial, and in his resurrection. Buried with Christ, raised to newness of life. So, Father, we pray that you would bless these waters of baptism tonight in the name of the Lord Jesus. And, Lord, may they be a way of sharing in union with him. We'll thank you for it in Christ's name. And everybody said, amen. Thank you.
Jesus into your heart as your Lord and Savior? He says yes. So upon your profession of faith, it is my honor. Make sure you hold your nose for me in your arm, okay? I ain't going to hold your nose for you, right? All right. It is my honor to baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. First, and now we go with sister, right? All right, Miss Danae Pledger, and Dad's watching at home, so, or from work, I think he's watching. So, all right, I got one question for you, Miss Danae. Have you accepted Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior? She says yes. So, Danae, upon your profession of faith, it is my honor to baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Accepted Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior? He says yes. We don't even get to finish the question. He says, yeah, I'm positive, 100%. That's a good thing. All right, hold your nose for me. Get ready. All right, Cohen, it is my honor because of your profession of faith to baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Certainly not least from our children's department tonight. I've got Mr. Noah Holland. Noah, will you look at me real quick? I got one question for you. I'm not going to confuse you. It's the same question I've asked all of them. That's right. All right. Have you accepted Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior? He says yes. All right, Noah, hold your nose for me. It is my honor because of your profession of faith to baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Thank you. baptism from a few weeks ago, and it's my honor to do this once again. So, Nick, have you accepted Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior?
I have.
Then it is my honor to rebaptize you in remembrance of your baptism in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
We're time to sing.
I won't go back. I can't go back to the way it used to be before your presence came and changed me.
Remember what it was like? Say, I won't go.
I won't go back. I can't go back to the way it used to be before your presence came and changed.
This is Miss Sabrina Williams. She comes tonight also just as a way of reaffirming and renewing her faith in the Lord Jesus. Sabrina, you want to share anything tonight? How many of you will support her in that fresh start tonight as her church family? Amen. Sabrina, because of your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, we baptize you in Christ Jesus in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Carry her through this. You give her strength to live out this commitment and this faith in Christ. because of your profession of faith in the Lord Jesus. We remember that you are baptized in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. My friend, Mr. Mitchell Boyette, and I had the honor of performing their marriage ceremony not too long ago, amen. So I'm just excited. Mitchell and Amanda are a great part of our church family. And tonight, this morning, Mitchell came and just made an all-in fresh commitment to the Lord Jesus Christ and wanted to celebrate that tonight in baptism. Mitchell, do you want to share anything tonight?
Yeah, I'm just ready to lay it down and go all in.
Amen. Will y'all support Mitchell tonight in that decision to follow Christ? Amen. Amen. Because of your profession of faith in the Lord Jesus, we baptize you into Christ in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Anybody else tonight? Anybody else tonight? Tonight's your night. Amen. If not, one more time, would you celebrate with these candidates who publicly profess faith in Christ tonight? And would you stand again? Let's let them know we love and support them. Let's continue to worship for tonight. One more time, give Jesus a great ovation of praise in the house tonight.
Well, one more time, I'm saying right now.
And right now is the moment. Today is the day I've been changed. I've been changed. I have waited for this moment to come, and I won't let it pass me by.
Breathing in life again.
Jesus, we love you.
Yeah, come on, church, say, oh, how we love.
Our hearts. Oh, how we love Jesus, we love you.
Oh, how we love
you. Oh, how we love you.
Oh,
you are the one our hearts adore.
Oh, what a Savior. Isn't he wonderful? Sing hallelujah.
Giving thanks to the Father who has qualified us to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in the light. He has delivered us from the power of darkness. He has conveyed us into the kingdom of the Son of His love. In Him we have redemption through His blood, even the forgiveness of sins. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn over all creation, for by Him all things were created that are in heaven and in earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or principalities or powers, all things were created through Him and for Him, and He is before all things, and in Him all things consist. And He is the head of the body, the church, who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in all things he might have the preeminence. Would you give him the greatest shout of praise you've given him all night tonight? The Lord. One more time, would you shout his praise in the house of God tonight? Give him glory and honor. Yes! Worthy are you, Lord. Great are you, Lord, and greatly to be praised. Hallelujah to your name, Jesus. Yes! Blessing and honor. Amen. Tonight, we are so thankful you chose to come and worship with us tonight. To celebrate those who've joined our church in membership and those who have identified with Christ through the sign and sacrament of baptism. Amen. We're thankful tonight. Guys, we're so proud of you. Every one of you who followed Jesus in baptism tonight, we are so proud of you. We're so thankful for your boldness to step up and confess Christ. Tonight, we are your church family, and our pledge is to stand with you and to walk with you on this journey. And to make sure you have all the friends and the strength and the help and the support that you need at any point along the journey to reach out and look around this room tonight. You've got a family. You've got a tribe. You've got a support network. You've got a circle of friends. You've got a group of people who will help you make it to heaven. Amen? Amen. Take advantage of that opportunity tonight. Amen? If you're new to the Forest Hill family, we'd love for you to come and check us out. Wednesday night is our next gathering time together. We'll be having classes on that night. Sunday mornings, 9 o'clock and 11 o'clock is when we meet for morning worship. We invite you to come and join us next Lord's Day. Amen. Tonight, aren't you thankful for his salvation, for his great love of us? Amen. Amen. I want to dismiss you tonight with the Lord's blessing, the words of Jesus from the New Testament. Would you receive this benediction from the Lord tonight? Amen. Amen. May the love of God the Father, and may the grace of the Lord Jesus, and may the fellowship of God the Holy Spirit be with us and remain among us throughout this week. In Jesus' name and for his sake we pray. And God's people said, amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. You are dismissed. Air high five somebody. We will see you Wednesday night and Sunday morning. The Lord bless you.